When Hurricane Tomas swept through Saint Lucia last month, leaving a trail of death and destruction, it also cut off road connections to several parts of the island. The Barre De Lisle was one example, where downed power lines, fallen trees and landslides blocked the area for days, making travel to and from the south of the island to Castries impossible via that route. St. Lucia's Minister for Communications, Works, Transport and Public Utilities says as a result, the Barre De Lisle remains the biggest concern in terms of vulnerable road routes.
It is something that we have known over the years, and when the late Sir John spoke about a tunnel under the Barre De Lisle, some people joked and laughed at it and thought that it was some far-fetched idea. But more and more we see the reality of bringing into place this tunnel, because I am not sure how long the Barre De Lisle can survive.
Minister Joseph says the government has taken a hard look at the Northeastern Quadrant Development Plan and the road network linking Denry with the north of the island. 18 miles of survey have already been completed on that stretch of road, and the current administration believes it can serve as a relief network. The passage of Hurricane Tomas, they say, has created both challenges and opportunities.
It shows our vulnerabilities, but it also creates opportunities and show the value of investing in new road networks that would help in making traveling a little easier around the island. It also brings into focus the issue of whether there should be total dependence on land transportation, or whether we should look at what used to be in the old days. I know my mother spoke about going to Soufre by boat.
The minister says given the size of the country and the terrain that it has, the government must explore all of its options. For the DBS News World, Jason Hollenseed reporting.